My family stands for family values, for the promotion of our European histories and cultures. We understand the importance of a strong civil society and try to contribute modestly with our foundation to the well-being of future generations. How do we do that? Look at the website of the foundation and read what we do. I think that the facts speak for themselves. The Erberg family was a sovereign family of the Holy Roman Empire of the German nation. Until the French Revolution, we had an independent duchy on the left bank of the River Rhine. And after the French Revolution, we had an independent duchy on the right bank of the River Rhine, more or less 3,300 square kilometers for a population of 800,000 people. But of course, since the early Middle Ages, we had a very strong footprint in the Low Countries. Low Countries meaning the Benelux countries, Holland, Belgium, and Luxembourg. We have a very long family history, nearly 1,000 years, and so we look at things, at the future, with a long-term view. We see ourselves not so much as individuals, but being part of a very long chain. We like nature, we like the land, we like the forest, we like beauty, beautiful buildings, beautiful gardens, real human contacts. We are skeptical about consumerism, and we certainly dislike waste. We are a fiercely independent family, and we put the survival of family above everything else, and this explains maybe why we survived so long. In the past, since we were at the top of the social ladder, we had to give back. You could not have a position of responsibility, of social responsibility in the long term over the generations without giving back to society. It was in that sense that you have to understand the old saying, noblesse oblige, in French. So we were building schools, hospitals, roads, orphanages. We were, let's say, involved in many economic activities, and we always tried to treat our people well. Before, we thought that we had to give the good example because we were in a leadership position. The example being the most important quality of leadership if you want to be at the front. But then you had the 60s, you had philosophers like Jean-Paul Sartre, and everything changed. Nowadays, we try to be ourselves and avoid following trends, new trends, just because they are new trends. We like honesty and modesty and the simple joys of life. We like real friendships and we like doing things together. It's what we try to offer within our Erberg Foundation. Yes, of course. We don't have a family castle here in Belgium anymore, and it's not a problem for me because owning a castle nowadays is a real burden for several reasons. But of course, we have adapted very well to modern times and to modern society, and we have places where we convene, where we come together twice, three times a year just to keep the family links alive. Castles are a very important part of our heritage, and also places tourists from all over the world want to visit. This is a huge challenge. It always was a huge challenge for every generation, and there is a learning curve for everybody. What seems to be extremely important for me nowadays is that once you have children, that means once you have accepted responsibility for young human beings, that you have to help them becoming responsible adults. So we try to give them a good sense of balance, and of self-esteem. And how do you do that? You have to spend time with them. You have to give them love and affection. What we always and also try to do within our family, we try to keep the family memory alive. How do we do that? We have published in the last 40 years, 6 books about our millennial family history. And we are working on the 7th book that is going to be published this year in English for a broad public. What I highly recommend is that all families try to write their own family histories. And we try to lead the way here. If you do that, if you can compare your own fate, your own destiny with the fate or the destiny of your grandparents, great-grandparents, whatever, it gives you much more stability and maybe a better perspective how to face your own problems in life. We had, let's say, many investments in mining, agriculture, forestry. We have done that for centuries in many, many countries. Nowadays, if I talk about myself here, if I speak about myself, I am a social activist for decades, a cultural entrepreneur, and also a businessman, because to pay for all activities of the Ehrenberg Foundation, you need to have some money. And thanks God, I have the backing of my family to achieve these goals. And let's say we also enjoy the support of other people on a case by case basis when they understand, let's say, the objectives we want to achieve together for the common good. First of all, I would like to remind the public that in Europe, we still have 10 monarchies, Belgium being one of those 10 monarchies. We have, a nobility that expands, more or less 1,200 noble families in Belgium, more or less 30,000 people out of a population of 11.3 million Belgians. The members of the nobility are the gatekeepers of our living, of our collective living memory. As such, they still have interesting archives. They own it personally, or it's, you know, part of a state archive. And they should put this memory at the disposal of research to promote our cultures and our histories. With their help, you know, this is possible because a lot of treasures are still to be discovered. And I think here especially about, you know, young people preparing doctorates who would be very happy to have fresh material to write about.